Da-di-da. Select all the buses. This is a bus. This is a bus. Was this a bus? This is too much effort. I give up. We've all been there, trying to sign up for something simple, and then bam, a reCAPTCHA appears. And at first glance, it's simple. But how much detail do they want? And is this really a thing that you want to spend time on? Suddenly, a task that should have taken 2 seconds could probably turn into this tedious process of proving that you're human. This is reCAPTCHA, and it's annoying, but also it's useless. It was created to stop bots from spamming websites, creating fake accounts, things like that. Because of this, websites just needed a way to tell if a user on it was human. Originally, it worked by testing if users could read distorted text like this. But as AI got better at solving these, it evolved into image recognition tests and checkbox challenges. In theory, if a user could complete this task, then that user must be a human and not a bot, and thus they could get access to the website. And yes, it is annoying when this pops up randomly asking you to complete this test. But this video isn't about reCAPTCHA being annoying. It doesn't work. And somehow it's still around. And it's making its current owner, who's this guy, billions of dollars. So before I tell you why reCAPTCHA doesn't work, and it doesn't, let's do a quick 2-minute history of reCAPTCHA. Originally, it started off as just being called CAPTCHA. CAPTCHA stands for Complete Automated Public Turing Test to Tell Computers and Humans Apart. It's a security measure that websites use to block bots from entering but allow humans to enter. It worked by asking users to read and type out distorted text. There were early versions of CAPTCHA floating around, but I would say that the first modern version of CAPTCHA was developed by researchers at the Carnegie Mellon University. It was led by Luis von Ahn, the same guy behind Duolingo. Now, back then, bots were around. It was before the breakthrough of AI and machine learning, but spammers could create simple bots to get through the websites and break the CAPTCHA. Scammers also employed people to solve the CAPTCHAs and break through the website. So even though normal CAPTCHAs worked for a while, as technology and AI improved, bots started cracking these CAPTCHAs pretty fast. So to adapt, something called reCAPTCHA was introduced around 2007. And unlike your standard CAPTCHA, reCAPTCHA took scanned text from books and newspapers that computers couldn't read and made the user interpret it. This in turn turned the challenge into something that actually helped users to digitize old documents. And because of this, this innovation caught the attention of Google. They acquired reCAPTCHA in 2009, and this was during the time where Google serviced around 100,000 websites in fending off bot spam. From there, Google started refining the system, leading to several versions of reCAPTCHA over the years. So the first version of reCAPTCHA, which was launched in 2007, was designed as a human-assisted OCR. Essentially, it turned people into unpaid book digitizers. Here's how it worked. Websites would show users 2 words. One word was known, and the other word was a suspicious word that computers just couldn't recognize. If the user typed correctly the known word, then their answer for the second word was assumed correct. After enough people typed the same thing, the word was officially considered valid and then added to the digitized document. In 2012, Google actually took this a step further. They decided to use images from Street View and ask users to identify things like crosswalks, street signs, and traffic lights. So this version of reCAPTCHA was popular, but it officially shut down in 2018. And by then, it already evolved into a next version. So reCAPTCHA evolved into reCAPTCHA V2, gaining popularity in around 2013. And it introduced behavioral analysis, meaning instead of just testing if you can solve a puzzle, Google started tracking how you interact with a website. By 2014, Google launched something called No CAPTCHA reCAPTCHA. This is where low-risk users had to just click a checkbox that says, I'm not a robot. And if Google wasn't sure about you, it will still show you a CAPTCHA challenge, now in the form of an image grid, where it asks users to select all the traffic lights, the buses, the crosswalks, etc. This update was meant to be more mobile-friendly, but it also became a bit more frustrating. Because sometimes, no matter what you clicked, you'd still get another test and another one and another one. Now, this version of reCAPTCHA is one that you still see on quite a lot of websites today. However, there is a newer version. In 2017, Google introduced reCAPTCHA version 3, which took a completely different approach. There was no checkboxes, no puzzles, no image grids. Instead, verification happens in the background, which is why you don't really see reCAPTCHA anymore. Google checks how you interact with a site and assigns you a risk score. The higher the score, the more human you seem. If your score is too low, then that's when the website might block you or even offer more verification. And on the surface, it seems like an improvement. No clicking endless traffic lights, no looking for buses. But it also means that users have zero control of whether they pass or fail. The system just decides for you. And by now you're thinking, well, that's interesting. It makes sense that reCAPTCHA evolved because technology evolved. So what's so bad about reCAPTCHA? Well, this one test doesn't work. In fact, reCAPTCHA as a whole didn't ever work. They were bad at blocking bots. And here's how bad reCAPTCHA is at blocking bots. So we all assumed that reCAPTCHA is a necessary security measure to protect websites from bots and automated spam. But in reality, it's actually failing at this one job. And it was failing from a long time. reCAPTCHA started with the text-based challenges, showing users distorted words and numbers and asked users to type it in correctly. And yes, at first it worked, but we know that as AI and technology improved, bots started crushing those text-based captures. Studies actually showed that at the time, machine learning algorithms could actually break captures with up to 99.8% accuracy, better than most humans. And there were several other studies done that confirmed this. In other words, the very task that was meant to block bots was actually easier for them to solve than for us. And this did make text-based captures useless, and it's probably why Google phased them out in favor of the image-based captures. But just like the text-based captures, bots learned quickly to beat the image-based captures as well. Multiple research studies have shown that AI models can solve reCAPTCHA version 2 image challenges with up to 85% accuracy. And other capture systems like hCAPTCHA have been broken with 96% accuracy. These tests, they just don't work. And then again, Google tried to improve it and introduced the I'm not a robot checkbox. And it doesn't really verify if you're human. Instead, what it does is track your cookies, your browsing history, and how your mouse moves. It's essentially one big spy. Interestingly, Google doesn't give much information on how this works. They just say that reCAPTCHA in general works by analyzing human behavior and other factors in order to determine if an action is performed by a human or by a bot. But apparently it is proper tracking. This research paper here looked at the reCAPTCHA risk analysis system and found that Google actually does track your cookies, browsing history, and browser environment, which includes canvas rendering, user agent, your screen resolution, your mouse movements, and it determines if you're a bot. So yes, this information may help determine if you're a bot or not, but that is a lot of information to track and to store. And here's a problem. Research has found that attackers can farm legitimate cookies and use them to bypass this reCAPTCHA with a 100% success rate, according to this paper. This paper also reported breaking reCAPTCHA at about 70%. It just doesn't work. And instead of blocking bots, reCAPTCHA is just becoming another tracking tool for Google. And it just looks like humans are doing more work because humans are still stuck clicking through endless image challenges while bots are sailing through. It just means that humans are doing more work for free. Since reCAPTCHA version 3 doesn't show any test, bots no longer have to solve anything. They just have to trick the system into thinking that they are low risk. In fact, researchers have already found ways to manipulate reCAPTCHA's version 3 scoring system by using reinforcement learning. And they achieved this with 97% accuracy with just 2,000 training samples used in the study. So any version of reCAPTCHA just doesn't seem to work. And if someone wants to get into your website, they'll just do it. So why are companies like Google still implementing it? Every time you solve a reCAPTCHA, you're not just proving you're human, you're actually doing some free work for Google. And this is nothing new. The blurry text captures from years ago, these were helping Google digitize books. The image captures, humans were helping Google actually classify AI images so that Google can use it for Google Maps and Street View and so on. Now, was it properly disclosed when the user was doing it? No, of course it wasn't. Apparently, just looking at reCAPTCHA version 2, this paper estimated that Google used 819 million hours of people's free time solving reCAPTCHAs, which equated to $6 billion in unpaid labor. Also, the internet bandwidth used to generate reCAPTCHAs is 7.5 million pounds of carbon dioxide emission. I don't know enough about the scale of CO2 emissions, but that does sound like a lot, especially since we all get bullied if we use a plastic straw. Now, even with the latest reCAPTCHA, which doesn't do much other than tracks your behavior to determine if you are a bot, Google still profits from that. Now, if you own a website, you do have to pay to use reCAPTCHA on your platform, so Google makes money through that. But also, tracking cookies, i.e. your behavior online, that is a byproduct of using reCAPTCHA. So Google uses reCAPTCHA and tracks your browsing habits. There's a problem because Google is a company that also creates ads, which is a problem because Google is a company which also sells ad space. So Google can track its users' behavior through these reCAPTCHAs and then serve us adverts that will appeal to our personality, our wants, based on our user behavior. And companies can pay Google for this data by using Google to serve their adverts to the right customers. This study also looked at this and determined that there were at least 329 billion CAPTCHA version 2 sessions, which obviously tracked cookies and user behavior, and the estimated value of these cookies were around $888 billion. The image challenges, which come up now and again, well, that labeled data is worth $32 billion. So every time you see a reCAPTCHA and you have to click on that bus, know that you're not proving that you're human. You're just helping Google make a few bucks. Thank you so much for watching. I know it's been a while since I last published a video. I will get back to publishing more consistently. Things have been just pretty crazy at the moment. Thanks for the support. Have a good one, and I'll see you next time, hopefully soon. Cheers.